birds flying high, you know how I feel. Sun in the sky, you know how I feel. Breeze drifting on by, you know how I feel. It's a new dawn, it's a new day. It's a new life for me, yeah. It's a new dawn, it's a new day. It's a new life for me.
Hi, I want you to just like state your name, where you're from. Just tell me a little about yourself.
I am from Atlanta, Georgia. That's where I grew up.
My name is Leah. I'm from San Francisco, California, the Greater Bay Area. About myself, I'm first year at Stanford, considering lots of different social sciences and humanities majors.
I'm Roscoe. I lived in Southeast Dallas my entire life. It's a neighborhood called Pleasant Grove. I would like to say there's not that much pleasant about it.
My first question is a very loose one. It's up for interpretation, but what does mental health mean to you?
I really think that mental health is about making sure that the way in which you process the world is healthy for us. Mental health deals with the way you process the world. And there are certain biological conditions that shape how we process the world, as well as certain environmental conditions that shape how we process the world.
Taking care of like your own mind, to me, is just as important as taking care of your physical body. Because like,
it's mind, body, and spirit.
Yeah, those things are just like, if you're not in the right mental place, you're not going to be able to be effective in like almost anything you're trying to do. Like, that kind of imbalance, if you have an imbalance with mind, body, or spirit, then like, it's just going to ruin your
day. You're not 100%.
Yeah, you're just not going to be the same.
I think it's just like a general part of health. I think like when we talk about health, we talk a lot about physical health. But I think mental health should be like, even though mental health is technically encompassed in that, I don't think we like consider that a part of it. And I think we should like take care of our minds and our souls the same way that we do our like physical bodies.
My mom, she's a psychiatrist. We were constantly aware of mental health and how that exists. But the difference was that we were able to take our understanding of mental health and kind of process it in the back of our minds, be able to identify things like,
succinctly, I think mental health is about developing a relationship with yourself.
Do you feel like there's a stigma towards mental health within
our community, probably?
Just within your experience?
At least within my experience,
yeah,
for sure. And every time, you know, he would, or my mom would make, you know, statements like, oh, they crazy. We would try to explain it to them, but I guess it's almost like,
in one ear out the other? Or?
Yeah, in one ear out the other. Or maybe they just don't really want to accept it. I don't know. And I'm not sure why. Not really sure why.
I would say the stigma is more so against the absolute medical. And when you say medical, and the black perception that usually refers to white people trying to tell you what's wrong with you.
Sure.
And there is a big objection to that because of the times in history, such as the Tuskegee experiments.
Definitely existed with your parents that therapy wasn't something for somebody
everyone
who's like healthy.
Yeah. Okay. Like if you needed therapy, something was wrong with you.
Right.
And honestly, I don't even like, I think that was almost a small part of it though. Like the largest part of it was what the perception would be. Like honestly, I think deep down inside my parents knew that things like that are important, but I think they feared a lot what the repercussions of it would be in terms of like access to opportunities.
The reason that when we go to get these jobs, we're dismissed at the door. The reason that when we go to shop, we're watched in your stores.
And I'm feeling good.
I'm gonna ask you, how do you take care of yourself at Stanford as a black man? Especially speaking towards, I don't know, your mental health, your physical health. Mm-hmm. Like, what are ways that you take care of yourself, you know, in this space that can sometimes just take over your life in a sense, you know?
My room is my room, and usually there's nobody else in my room. So my room, at least, is a pretty good space for me to escape from you know, all the different things and people that, you know, are at Stanford.
I use CAPS. I use Maiden. So, yeah, I go to a therapist here. So it's just like somebody to help you unpack your experience. And the thing with therapy is that you're talking to another human. They just have a professional lens, and they're able to really help you to kind of give you professional strategies to help you through that.
Sure.
They're still a human. Oh, and then I also use a psychiatrist here as well. Here also, I go to Wendover sometimes. It's right by our dorm, Benjamin. Also, I talk to people. As you can see, I'm talking a lot right now.
Yeah.